Mooi, hè?
Mooi, ja, heel mooi.
There's no water.
No, it's dried out.
Hi, guys. We're in the woods. And I'm going to collect dried leaves. This will be perfect for my DIY compost. Yay! Oh, this will be perfect for my garden!
So in today's video, I'll be showing you how to make your own compost. At your home, at your own garden, or even if you don't have a big space, or you just live in a small apartment with a small balcony, of course, it's possible to make your own compost at home. It sounds intimidating, but it's really not that hard as you might think, as long as it's done correctly. That's why I'm here to guide you how to do it the right way. First of all, what does compost mean? And why we should compost? Compost is a mixture of organic materials such as decayed plants, vegetable waste, or kitchen waste, which is added to the soil as a fertilizer. If you have seen my videos about 12 things that I love about the Netherlands, and if you haven't, I'll be sharing the link down below. One of those was, it's so easy to garden in the Netherlands. And I mentioned there that the soil in the Netherlands is relatively rich in soil organic matter, mainly because majority of the Dutch population recycle their waste. And that includes by doing your own compost at home. There are two main reasons why we should compost at home. It's fun and rewarding. It's fun because you see results, and just imagine how your junk or waste from unappealing and yucky smell and turns into a pleasant and earthy smell like a new soil. And of course, it's rewarding because if you succeed in composting, you feel you're like a bona fide gardener. And of course, you help in reducing household waste. Currently, food scraps, yard waste make up more than 28% of what we throw away, which should be composted instead. So composting, guys, is not just about improving the quality of your soil or help your plants grow healthy, but it's great for our community and environment. So I really encourage you to compost at home. So let's begin how to do it. We purchased online a 260 liters of compost bin. I'm not going to use this now. I'm planning to use this at the end of fall because, as we all know, during fall, you will find a lot of dried leaves everywhere in the neighborhood, and I don't need to go to the woods just to collect dried leaves. So in the meantime, I'm going to use a small container in making my own compost. And since this video is about composting, not only for big garden and also for people who have small space at home or just living in a small apartment. This type of container, it comes with lid. I got this from very long time, so I'm not sure exactly what's the size of this, but it's very common type of container. You can easily find this in any big supermarkets. Or if you're from the Netherlands, I remember I saw this from Action. To begin with, we need a drill to make holes of the container at the bottom and all sides of the container as well. For safety, if you're not sure how to use the drill, then it's better to seek help from your husband or someone who knows how to use it. There are four major elements of composting that we need in order to make our compost successful. And these are, number one, nitrogen. Or they call it the greens, such as grass clippings, weeds, kitchen waste like vegetable peelings, fruit scraps, even eggshells, and coffee grounds. Please never include dairy products, meat, and even oils in your compost, and even pets' waste are not recommended because they can carry harmful bacteria and germs that can contaminate your compost. Plus, as they rot, it smells very terrible. And the second element that we need in composting is the carbon, also known as the browns. These are the dead leaves or dried leaves, twigs, branches, and even newspapers. And the third element that we need in composting in order to keep the mixture moist, and it's very important for the compost development because it helps break down the organic matter, and that's the water. And lastly, we need air in order to make our compost odor-free, and that's the reason why we made holes not only at the bottom and also at the sides of the container, because this will increase the number of microorganisms, which speeds up the process of composting. For today's compost, I will be using coffee grounds, which are an excellent source of nitrogen and close to pH neutral between 6.5 to 6.8 pH, which is good for our soil. If you don't have coffee grounds at home, you can easily get this for free from any coffee shops. Like for my case, I got it from my work. And we have eggshells and tea bags. Eggshells are rich in calcium that helps plants build cell walls, while tea bags are terrific for the health of the plants and promotes earthworms. And of course, majority of our kitchen waste are coming from fruits and vegetable scraps, including citrus peelings. There are plenty of mixed articles that tells you, either warns you not to use citrus peelings or tells you it's okay to use citrus peelings in composting. Well, in my experience, for me, it works as long as you chop them before adding to your compost bin. I also have fresh weeds that I just pulled out from the garden. I usually use grass clippings, but for today, we did not mow the grass. And for the carbon source, I have here dead or dried leaves, which we got from the woods. Dried leaves are gold for garden soil and necessary element for composting. And I also have papers. I'm using brown papers. You can use any type of papers. They are safe to use except for colored ones or glossy paper because they might contain toxic heavy metals. Now that we have all the right ingredients that we need in composting, we just need to layer them similar to making a lasagna. But I always start with the browns and then the greens. I usually put two parts of browns and one part of greens. So just repeat the same process until you reach 80 to 90% of your container, so there will be enough space for you to mix them occasionally and there will be room for air. Once you're done layering, water the mixture just enough to give moisture and should not be very wet. And then cover your bin and make sure that you place your bin in a dry place and shady area. So in just 1 week, this is now how our mixture looks like. Just see the mixture that it's already shrunk into almost half of the container. That means this process is effective. To speed up the process, it's always recommended to chop and shred all your materials before layering in your bin with regular mixing or turning your bin.
Nice smell, huh?
Yeah, very nice.
So that's how simple to make your own compost at home. Your compost should be ready within 2 to 5 weeks depending on what materials and how much amount you piled in your compost. As long as you follow those key elements that I've mentioned on this video, including my tips for quicker results. So I hope again you find this video very helpful, and if you did, please don't forget to like and subscribe and click the notification bell so that you'll be notified as soon as I upload the next video. I'll see you in the next one!